Next, we will see the aptitude questions that are asked in the 2019 prelims paper. So before we go into the problems, I would like to emphasize again the same, you know, known points. Okay, but why I'm you know, emphasizing again and again? Because you need to, this really plays an important role in our exam. Okay, so what are those? First of all, all these are easy concept. Okay, everyone knows this, but only thing is time consuming. Okay, so if you can able to complete these within less amount of time, then you are able to save your time, precious time for the other question. Why? Because these competitive exams, all about this competitive exam is how you manage your time. So if you are able to complete within the time with the precision, then you will get into the, you know, next stage. And here it's always better to attempt at the starting. You know, the math and aptitude both together, it's always better to attempt at the starting. Why? Because if you look at the previous questions, math and aptitude, it is not that much deep. Okay, they are asking a basic level question. So what happens if you trying to attempt at the end? For example, if you look at the, you know, set D in this year, what happened? They have given the aptitude questions at the end. So if you try to save these for the end, then what happens? Because of the pressure, you are may not be able to think properly, and here you may lose marks in this. Why I'm specially emphasizing on math and aptitude here is other subject, the probability of, you know, being correct in other subject questions is 50-50, because there it's a most of the time guesswork. So they give two sentences and you need to guess it, and based on our discretion power and then common sense we will choose. But whereas here we are not going to use any discretionary power. Only thing is, if you know the procedure, you do it, then definitely you will get the answer. That means here these are having the definite answers. These are having the definite answers and the solutions. Okay. So if you know the procedure, that's it. You will get the answers for this. And most of the time you know the procedures. So don't postpone these for the end, because you will definitely get marks here if you are able to solve this. Understood? So that is why don't postpone to the end. And one more thing is, don't neglect the practice. See, the majority trend here is people are concentrating on more on current affairs and some other unknown subjects, and they are not minding that this math and aptitude are also having the same, you know, amount of the what we call that, you know, weightage. Okay, so for example, many people are very much worried, you know, how much read current affairs, current affairs, how many questions may come, approximately something like 5 to 6 are okay, at max 10. But even though you read tons of material for the current affairs, I am sure you are not able to attend more than 5 or 6 questions. Okay, even if you follow all the institute's material. But whereas aptitude, you can solve each and every question, aptitude and maths. Okay, so don't neglect the practice thinking that you can easily manage. What is the meaning of the practice here? The practice doesn't mean that knowing the procedure and the formulas. The practice means how to do within a short period, a short time. Okay, that is what we need to do. Okay, so you please remember all these points are, you know, anyway known to you, but again please remember this. Okay, so we will start with the question number 25 in the Saturday. So consider the following diagram. So diagram I have already drawn here. So where AC is the diameter of the large circle and AB equal to BC. What is the meaning of AB equal to BC? AB equal to BC, that means it is a square. Okay, the ratio of areas of the large circle to the small circle of a square. So what they are asking, we need to find out, let's say A is the area of the capital D, means large circle, and area of the small circle. So first here, let's understand what they have given. So this is a bigger circle. Inside a bigger circle there is a square. Okay, and again inside the square there is one more smaller circle which is inscribed in a such a way that it is touching all the midpoints of the square like this. Okay, so here they are asking this, what is the formula for that? Let's say the diameter of the bigger circle is a capital D, and what is the diameter of the small circle? This is the diameter of the small circle, small d. So that is a pi by 4 d square divided by
pi by 4 small d square. So we need to find out the relation between capital D and smaller d. Okay, and since it is already mentioned that the AB equal to BC, that means it is a square. Here AD and DC is nothing but the diameter of the smaller circle. So here we need to take the triangle. Triangle ADC. In the triangle ADC, you know, AC square equal to AD square plus DC square. Okay, so Pythagoras theorem. See, most of the times in the aptitude, you will get the Pythagoras theorem. So always it's better to remember some of the, you know, Pythagoras triplets. What is the meaning of that? For example, 5 square equal to 3 square plus 4 square. Like that, you know, at least 5 to 6 triplets you need to remember by heart so that it will come handy. So here, if I substitute d square equal to small d square plus small d square. So capital D square by small d square equal to 2 here. Okay, so what is the value here? The value here is 2 is to 1 if it is in terms of the ratio. Okay, option is C. So next is question number 90 in the Saturday. Again, these questions are easy. See, that's why you should not keep this aptitude for the end. So what is the question? A person traveled by a car 70 km towards the north and he reaches the point A and then covered 30 km turning left to B, and again he turned towards left and traveled 110 km to the C, and again then he cycled at the rate of 10 km per hour towards the starting point. The time taken by him to reach the starting point from the C will be. So here it is an easy question. So first we will draw the directions. See, here this is the north, south, east and then west. Okay, these are the direction and this is the point origin. So what is the first step he did? He traveled 70 kilometers to the north. So up to here he traveled 70 kilometers. So it is a 70 kilometers. And after that what he did? He took left turn and traveled 30 kilometers. So for example here, this is the person. He traveled up to here. When he is traveling, what is the left and right of him? Left side is towards the west and right side is towards the east. Why he is facing the north side? If he is facing the south side, his left will become east and right will become west. Okay. Based on his facing, the left and right will changes. Okay. That is the only key here. So he took left turn. Left turn means here. He took left turn and he traveled 30 kilometers. This is a 30 kilometers and he reached the point B. And again here he took again the left turn. So here in this case he is facing the direction west. Okay, when he is facing the direction west, his right side is north and left side is south. Okay, and again here he traveled continuously 110 kilometers. So this is already 70 and this is a 40. Okay, this is the point C, and here from the point C to O he reached back again, and this they have mentioned the, for this path they have mentioned the velocity. Velocity is equal to 10 kilometer per, you know, hour. They mentioned hour. So they are asking how much time it took from traveling from C to O. So here the formula is velocity equal to distance. Distance d divided by time. So t equal to d by v. So we know v, we need to find out the d. D is from c to o. C to o. Okay. So this is a 30. Again, this is a 40, and this is a Pythagoras theorem 50. So that is a 50 divided by 10. That means 5 hours. Okay. So here the only key in this question is how to choose left and right of a person based on the direction to which he is facing. Okay, and this is also easy question. You should not lose marks in such type of questions. Option is B. So next question is 91. A student purchases some books for you know ₹1600. So his student purchased books for 1600, and if he had bought 8 more extra books than the previous one, whatever he purchased, for the same amount, for the same 1600, then there is a discount and each book would cost 10 rupees less than whatever he purchased previously. Okay, then the number of books he buys. So we need to find out how many number of books he bought. Okay, so these are all standard questions. These are all standard type of questions. These are all easy, but we don't have calci, so they are no longer easy. It is a time consuming. If you can able to save time in these type of questions, then you are able to score more in the other questions. Okay, so what is telling? The books he is buying, the books, so number of books. So number of books equal to n. I will say number of books equal to n, and cost of the each book. Cost of each book, I don't know that also. So that equal to x. So initially he bought n number of books for the cost of x. So n into x equal to how much it is costing? 1600 rupees. Okay. And now what I, in the second case, what happens if he had bought 8 books extra, that means n plus 8, then the cost of the each book will be reduced by 10. And you will get the 1600. That means for the same 1600 you are getting 8 more books if you had ordered. Okay, so here they are asking the number of books, that is n. So this is the standard problem, and you substitute x in wherever you have, so in terms of n, then you will get the n. That is the standard problem. Okay, so here why they are giving two conditions? Because here there are two unknown variables, and we need two equations, then only you are able to solve those. This is the standard one. So as soon as you get this, then what we need to do, n plus 8 into 1600 divided by n minus 10 equal to 1600. So this is how we attempt. Okay, we will start solving this quadratic equation, and we will end up in a time consuming, most of our time consuming on this problem. So then immediately you go to the options. Okay, so immediately you go to the option, and I will take the first option. And see here what happens, this is a RHS, right hand side, and a LHS. So I will choose the n in a such a way that the RHS should become the LHS. Okay, 1600. So here what is the factors of the 1600? 1 into 16, 2 into 8, 4 into 4, and 16 into 1. And if there is any fraction, even in that case also we may get, but most of the time if the calci is not allowed, they may not ask the fractions. Okay, so first I will go to the first option, 30. So if I substitute option one, so n equal to 30. So if I substitute n equal to 30, then what happened here? So 38 into 16, 100 divided by 30 minus 10. So it will become a fraction. It will become a fraction. See, if you multiply 38 with a fraction, you may not get the 1600. Okay, then I will skip to the next option immediately. You need to skip immediately. Here n equal to 32. If I take n equal to 32, here what is happening? N plus 8 is 40 into here 16, 100 divided by 32. So 16 will go 2 times in the 32, and you will get a integer value. Okay, so here if you do this, then you will get a 50 minus 10. Okay, this I will write here. This is the 50 minus 10, that equal to 40. So 4 into 4, 16, 1600 we are getting. So here what is the key? As soon as I see the formula in this way, then I will choose the n in such a way that the 16 and n will go very easily. Okay, they should cancel very easily. Then okay, so here which is cancelling with the 16? Only 32 is cancelling. So that is how you need to choose the answer. You should not solve the quadratic equation. Okay, understood. For example, if I substitute 36, it is not going so easily with the 16. You will end up in the fractions. In that case, don't choose that. So you choose in one answer which will easily cancel with the 16 here. Why? Because the main problem with in this equation is we have a division, so it should go easily with the 16. Okay, that is how we need to go. So option is 32. So in this way, this is just a, you know, 30 to 40 seconds question. If you start solving this blindly, then it takes a lot of time. Okay, please don't do that. Don't do that mistakes. Next question is 92. So hey, hemisphere means half of the hemisphere. Hemisphere depression is cut out of from one face of the cubical wooden block such that the radius r of the hemisphere is equal to the of the edge of the cube. What will be the surface area of the remaining solid? So here what's happening, we have a wooden cubical block like this, wooden cubical block like this. So here I am start cutting, you know. For example, if I see from the top, this is, let's say, block is like this, this is a front view, and if I see from the top, exactly it looks like the same. Okay, let's say this is a front view and this is the top view. Okay, this is the top view. So what happened here, on the top view I am digging out, from the top face I am digging out some hemisphere. Okay, so here where should I start, hemisphere like this or like this? So for that they have given the relation. What is that? The radius of the hemisphere is of the length of the side. So here it is a 2r, let's say it is a 2r, then here the radius, if it is starting from 0, radius is r to r, from here to here r and here to r r, so it is equivalent to the 2r. That means the hemisphere that is cut out is touching all the faces of it. Okay, so it will start from here and it will go like this. Okay, that is why they have given that condition. So if you see in the top view, it will be like this. So it will be like this. So this is the hemisphere. So here what they are asking, we need to find out the remaining surface after the cutout. So here there may be chances that you may miss out this portion when you are finding the total surface area. See this red color hatched portion, you may miss out. Okay, that is the only thing twist here in this question. So here what is the surface area, total surface area after that? See, there are six surfaces on the cube, but in one of the surfaces we are cutting, so remaining five surfaces will be intact, there will be no change in that. So 5 into area of the cube plus here the concave surface, this is the concave surface. Okay, so after cut out it will become like this. So this is the concave surface, the concave surface area also we need to find out. So A of concave and this hatched portion, that means area of top face, actually this is the remaining area on the top face, this is the remaining area. Okay, so what is the area of the cube, I mean area of the face of a cube, this is a 2r and this is a 2r. Okay, so 5 into 2r into 2r plus what is the area of the concave, what is the total surface area of this PM, that is a 4 pi r square. We some of the basic solids you need to buy heart these formulas, what is the volume, what is the surface area. Okay, for example for the cone, for the cylinder and for the sphere, even the moment of inertia formulas and the center of gravity, so these are now standard and you need to buy heart like anything, there is no other way. Okay, so 4 pi r square, if you don't know 4 pi r square, is the total surface area of the sphere, then you know your question will be wrong, answer will be. So that is for the full sphere, but here it is only hemisphere, that means 2 pi r square plus the remaining portion is this. So we are neglecting, for example if you see the projected area, this is the projected area, the projected area of the hemisphere is seen as a circle here. Okay, so the total surface area of the square, that is a 2r into 2r, and we need to neglect this. What is that? That is a pi r square. Okay, we need to neglect that. So here this is 2 into 2 4, 4 into 5 20 r square and here one more room 4 r square. So it will become 24 r square and here 2 pi r square minus pi r square. So it is a pi r square and if I take the r square common then it will become pi plus 24. Okay. So what is the option here? The option is B here. So here the only key is you may forget to take this portion. Okay. That is the only key here. A rod of length L is to be divided into two parts. It is not equally divided, to be divided only just two parts. Okay. Such that if the x 5 times the smaller portion, that means 5 into x is added to the half of the larger portion, half means y by 2, then it is always be less than the L. In that case, you know, in which this can be achieved by taking length of the larger portion more than, you know, which of the option. Okay. Again, this is a formation of two equations, that's it. What is given first, you know, here total length is L, so x plus y equal to L. Here we have equality. And what is the next case is telling 5 times the smaller length, that is 5 into x plus half of the larger length, that is 5 by 2, half of the larger portion is always less than the total length of the rod, that is the L. Here we have one equality, another one is inequality. So whenever you have inequality, you may not expect the exact solution, exact answer in the options. Okay. So that is the only key here, that is the only twist here. If you expect the exact solution in the options, then you may get confused. Why? Because here you may get some other option answered and here they may give some other thing. Okay. It is based on the logic whatever you are getting here. This you need to remember. Whenever there is no equality, then you don't expect the exact answer in the option. So here again we need to find out the larger portion, that is a y. So same formula, same procedure, you need to substitute x in terms of L and y. So it will become 5 into L minus y plus y by 2 less than L. If I simplify this 5L this side and L I will take from, you know, other side, and I will take this minus 5, so this is a 4L. How much it will become? Minus 5 plus y by 2 minus 5y plus y by 2. Then if I LCM it, then it will become minus 9y by 2, that is less than 0. That means y is greater than 8L by 9. So this is the option. Is there any option here? No option here. So you know, in the first instance you may think that answer is not matching and you will go back and search the, you know, whether you made any mistakes, and it will consume some time, 1 or 2 minutes, and you leave this and move on to the other question. Okay. That is the problem with these type of questions. Whenever there is no equality here, it is a not equality, it is a greater than. Okay. And now there is a greater than other than equality, then option may not be the same, but you need to use the logic. What is the logic? The y value should be more than the this value. What is this value? This is approximately 9. How many times it will go in the 80? It is 8 times approximately. So 0.88L, this is the value. So whatever option which is more than 0.88L, you need to choose that. Okay, whichever is more than that. So here 9 by 10 is nothing but 0.9L. okay, this is more than this. Okay, this is more than this. Generally, if these type of questions are there, if he may not give, the examiner should not give two values which are more than 0.88. You need to remember that if he is giving you two values more than 0.88, you can choose any one of them and you should get the marks. So first answer itself, first option itself is more than 0.88, then you blindly choose this value. Blindly answer is yeah, that's it. You know, you can move on to the next question. But anyway, we will see other values. What are those other values? Okay. So the second one is, it is approximately 0.875L, which is less than the 0.88. Okay. And the next one is 857. And the third one is 5/6, 0.838. See here, he can give only one value. He cannot give two values which is more than 0.88. Okay,